The only thing you have to do is die horribly. Everything else is optional. Hello, I'm Norethan Devlin. In my last video, I covered reason, inductive and deductive reasoning, among other things. This video is primarily about logic. Logic is the correct principles of reasoning. That is, reasoning in a coherent and reasonable manner. Logic can be as easy as 1, 2, 3. We will take a premise or a proposition. We will propose that 1 equals 1. This is my starting premise. Then we will take a second premise, in this case, plus 2. So, 1 plus 2. Then we can draw the conclusion, 1 plus 2 equals 3. That's it. It can be that simple. It can also become horribly complicated. You can have many premises. The logic more commonly used in video debates is in the form of argumentation logic. Let me demonstrate. This is my argument. All humans are mortal. All humans die. You are human. Therefore, you will die. Horribly. One way of thinking about logic is to think about sets. So, all humans are mortal goes into the set, all humans. You are human goes into the set, you are human. If the two premises are correct, and if these two sets fit together without contradiction, then it follows logically that the conclusion is correct. You will die horribly. Now, had I said all humans have green eyes, then this would be a false premise. Even though the conclusion is still correct, you will die horribly. Logic is about using the correct principles in argumentation, not necessarily the conclusion. Logic can take many forms: syllogistic, Boolean, modal, first-order predicate. The list is extremely large. I won't cover them all, because I don't know them all. These types of logic work on the principle that something is either true or false, with no middle ground. The law of excluded middle. These are your standard types of logic, and the most commonly used. There is, however, fuzzy logic and probabilistic logic, which do have some middle ground, but they're not so commonly used. There are forms of logic that use set definitions, like mathematics or symbols, where the premise is well defined and well understood, but these types of logic are extremely boring, so I won't go into them. General argumentation logic lacks these clearly defined premises, so one must be astute in checking premises for any possible error. Although false premises can lead to a correct conclusion, this is not the correct principles of reasoning if errors have occurred. I think that will do for now. Your comments are appreciated. Thank you for listening.